to Psych IRL. My name is Donna. So in last week's video, we talked about cognitive dissonance. Today's video is going to be a part two to that video, but we're going to be talking about it in a more practical sense.
Mind control, guys.
So a brief explanation of cognitive dissonance is when you have two conflicting thoughts. When you have two conflicting thoughts, you experience dissonance or discomfort because you want consistency. Let's take, for example, the smoker. Most smokers know that smoking is bad for you, yet they still smoke. Why? Probably because their dissonance is reduced. And how do they reduce this dissonance? One way is they could be like, you know what, I'm actually just a social smoker, so I don't really smoke that much. Dissonance reduced. So if you're still confused about what cognitive dissonance is, I talk about it more in detail in last week's video. That'll be down in the description below, so be sure to check that out. Other than that, let's get started. Number one, if you want people to love your club or organization, make the initiation process really difficult. People usually equate a high amount of money, effort spent on something, and time to something of quality. So if your club happens to be subpar, if your initiation process is really hard, they will equate your club as of high quality because of the difficult initiation process. This is called effort justification. In 1959, Aronson and Mills recruited female participants for a study. They were told they were going to partake in this sex discussion group. But wait! Before they could participate in this group, they had to pass a test, an initiation test. Little did they know, the participants were going to be split into three groups. Group 1 wasn't going to partake in any test. Group 2 was going to partake in a mild, easy initiation test. Group 3 was going to partake in a pretty difficult initiation test. After all the tests were done, they find out the sex discussion group that they get into is actually just a really boring talk about the mating cycle of bees.
Bees.
Then after that discussion, the participants rated how enjoyable the discussion was. Results show that participants in group 3 rated the discussion as more enjoyable than those participants in the other two groups. Number 2, when you want to persuade someone with a different opinion than you, make them partake in self-affirmation. Self-affirmation is bolstering our own identity or self-esteem by highlighting important values we have within ourselves.
I'm pretty good at math.
I'm a nice person. So as human beings, we think we're rational and logical. And when someone has a different opinion than you, that threatens your self-identity because you think humans are all logical and rational. So why don't you agree? Claude Steele and his colleagues found out that when one partook in self-affirmation, they were more open to persuasive information that wasn't in alignment with their opinions. Number 3, if you want to make friends, ask them to do you a favor. Earlier, I explained cognitive dissonance as when one has two conflicting thoughts, but it can also be a conflicting thought and a conflicting behavior. BEM's self-perception theory says, people come to know their own attitudes by looking at their behavior and the context which it occurred, and inferring what their attitude must be. Hey, can I borrow a pencil?
Sure.
Wait, why did I just let her borrow a pencil? Oh, I must like her and want to be her friend, duh. Number 4, if you want to build confidence for a job interview or a date, pose like this prior to your date or job interview. So self-perception theory is also affected by movement. Certain poses are universal. For example, if you're feeling victorious or dominant, you might pose like this. If you're feeling scared or submissive, you might pose like this. Amy Cuddy and her colleagues decided to investigate these poses. Can the mere act of posing in these poses affect us? Participants were split into several groups. Two of the main groups were posing in high power poses or posing in low power poses. They were to pose in their assigned poses for 1 minute. After that minute was over, they were then told to imagine themselves at the perfect scenario. They were in a job interview for their dream job. They then had 5 minutes to prepare a speech on why they would be the perfect candidate for this job. Results show that people who partook in the high power poses for 1 minute did better on the job interview and reported higher confidence than people who partook in the low power poses. So before a date or a job interview, if you want to feel confident, do some power poses for a minute or two. That's the end of the video. Articles are always down in the description below. If you decide to do one of these life hacks, be sure to tell me. Hit me up on Twitter or whatever. I will see you guys next time. Stay psyched.
I can stop eating hot Cheetos and therefore be healthier.
The second way is I can reduce a belief. So I can say, you know what? Hot Cheetos aren't really that bad.